In this lesson, we are going to see how to work with the file. Basically, the target of this lesson is to read the content of the file and write into the file. For that, the syntax that the Python gives is we need to provide a variable name. Basically, the variable to which we want to store a file content or a file, and then we have to use an open function to which we have to pass the file path, including the file name, so that it can open that file and give us the file object. Now, let's see the working example. For this example, we will need two files. One, a text file to which we are going to put 2 to 3 lines. Let's say this is a first line, this is a second line, and this is a third line. And then we will need another file where we are going to write our Python code. So let's create a variable name as file name equal to test.txt. Then we are going to open this file. So let's say file underscore obj equal to open, and we are going to provide the file name as a value to this, and then we are going to print this file object first to see exactly what this file object or the file obj variable holds. Let's run our program, python print file.py, and see the output. We provided test.txt file name, which we ask it to read using an open function, and then we try to print the file. So the file that we gave using the open function, we gave it to a variable file underscore obj, and that variable is nothing but the file object, and hence instead of giving the content, the print statement gave us what that file obj or the variable holds. So it says that the variable holds a text IO wrapper object which has name as test.txt, it's open in read mode, and its encoding standard is UTF-8. So these mode and encoding are two parameters that we can pass to the open function that we will see later on. Now let's see how to read the content of this file. So let's create function file obj dot read, and let's print the content. Now let's execute our program. Python read file.py, and see the content that we printed is properly as it is, which we entered in test.txt file. So using open, we are able to read a file which is right now available in the current folder. But what if the file name that we provide is wrong? Or the file path that we provide is wrong. Let's see that. So here we have file name equal to test, but instead of test, if I say test1.txt and execute this program, let's see the output. Python read file.py, and see it says file not found error, because the test1.txt file does not exist in the current directory, and hence the error. We can also provide path of the entire file. So let's see how to do that. Now let's use the file path. So I'll create a variable file underscore path equal to, and I already have copied the path of this file, so I use that. Now this is a Linux standard path because it is using forward slash. On Windows, the path will be with the backslash. So you might have to use C colon the entire path, which you can get easily from the command prompt. Then we are going to change this. Now we have this file path and the file name, but we want to make sure that we join them together and then pass that as a parameter to the open function. But we need to use a separator. We can either hard code that like here I did, or the other way is to import a module called as OS, which provides us a function to join the file path. So, dot path dot join, and then to this join function we can pass file path and the file name as a parameters. Now let's execute this program. Python read file.py, and see, so we are able to get the content of the file and print it. Now see the difference. Earlier when we provided just test.txt, it looked for that file in the current directory and just gave us the name. But here you can see it has given us the entire path. The reason being, when we pass that entire path, that is given to a parameter to a name variable, and hence we got the entire name value as the path and the name of the file. In this example, we are going to use argv that we learned in command parameters to ask user to enter the file name that he or she wants to create, and then ask user to enter 2 to 3 lines which will be written into the file. So let's start. So from sys import argv, then we are going to the script comma file name equal to argv. Now we want to open this file in a write mode, so for that we will be using file obj as a variable to which we are going to assign the file object given by the open function. So for this open function we are going to provide the file name and the mode in which we want to open this. So we want to open it in a write mode. Now we have this file in a write mode. Since we are opening this file in a write mode, we cannot read the existing content of this file. The only thing that we can do is write into the file. So let's ask user to enter some values. So let's say, please enter 3 lines to write in a file. Then on the next line we say line underscore 1 equal to input, and enter line 1, then line underscore 2 equal to input, enter line 2, line underscore 3 equal to input, enter line 3. Then we are going to take these 3 lines and write those in a file using write function on our file object. So let's say file underscore obj dot write, and to which we are going to pass line 1, then file underscore obj dot write, to which we are going to pass line 2, and same with line. Now let's run this program and see whether we are able to get the file or not. Before we run our example, I would like to check whether there is any file named as testwrite.txt. So let's run ls command. So here you can see we have 3 files, 2 Python files, create underscore file.py and read underscore file.py, and one text file which we created earlier for reading the content. Now let's run our example. Python create file.py, and let's provide it a file that test underscore write dot txt. So now enter the first three lines, let's say first line, second line, third line. So our program has ended. Since this is a write mode, we cannot read the content of the file, but let's see whether the file is created or not. So here you can see the new file test underscore write.txt is created. So if everything is fine as the code that I have given you, you should also see this new file created. Now let's see the content of this file. So now I'm going to run a new command, which is a cat command, which allows us to read the content of the file. So see, this has first line, second line, and third line. Now let's open this file in our editor just for the clarity. So here we can see we provided three lines, first line, second line, and third line. So the variable values are printed properly, but we were expecting them to be printed on the new line. Instead, they are printed on the same line. Why is it happening? Because the write function just keep on writing the content of the variable from the current progress bar, which is always going to be the last point where the line has been written, and hence all the lines are written in the one single line inside a file. To put the new line, we need to make sure that we provide the slash n command to the write function. So we are going to add that. So file obj dot write, and let's provide slash n, and I'm going to copy it and paste it three times. Now let's run our program again. Program Python create underscore file test underscore write dot txt and press enter. So let's enter our line. Just to make it different, the first line, the second line, the third line. Now let's read the file in the editor. Now here we can see all our lines are now on a separate line as we expected. So we need to use slash n whenever we are writing onto the new line. Now here we saw the write mode, and earlier we saw a read mode. By default, whenever we are opening a file, the file is open in a read mode if we do not provide any mode as a parameter to this open function. So here we provided w as a parameter, which indicates we are trying to open this file in a write mode. But whenever we are opening the file in a write mode, we should always make sure that we are providing this w as a mode. Otherwise, if we do not provide, the file will be open by default in a read mode. Of course, we can always provide r as a mode for reading the content of the file. There is one more mode in which we can open this file, which is an append, which allows us to append to the file. Now, why do we need an append mode when we have a write mode? The reason being, when we open a file in a write mode, it will always start writing from the starting line of the file. Even if there is already content existing in the file, it will start overwriting on that content. And hence, we should always make sure that we open a file either in write mode or an append mode, depending on our requirement. Now, let's modify our program a little bit. Instead of writing three lines, we are going to write only two lines into the same file. And here we can see we have three lines written. So let's run the program. So we are going to write into the same file, but this time we are just going to enter two lines. Let's say first line, second line. So since we just provided two lines, now let's see the output. So here we can see that the two lines that we entered were written properly, but the third line, which was there earlier, is also removed. The reason being, the write mode or a W mode will always open a file in writing, and it will start writing from this first line, and hence entire content will be overwritten. Now, if we want to append to this line over here, we should always open this file in the append mode. So for that, we need to use A as a character. So instead of W, we need to open it using A so that we can append. Now let's see how can we read from one file and write into the another file. So in this example, we are going to ask user to enter three commands, basically name of the Python file that we want to run, from file and to file. So from file is going to be the file from which we are going to read the content, and to file is the file where we are going to write the content. So for that, we will need to import the argv from the sys library. Then we are going to say script comma from file comma to file equal to argv, and then we are going to open each file. So let's first read the from file object. Here we are going to pass from file comma the mode is R. So same thing we can always write like this, mode equal to R. Then we are going to read the entire content of this file from file obj dot read. Then we are going to open another file, which is a to file. So let's say to file underscore obj equal to open to file comma mode equal to write. Now we are going to write into this file. So to file obj dot write, and the content will be copied. Now let's execute this program. Now before we proceed, let's see the current files present. So it says there are three Python files, create file.py, read file.py, and read write.py. And then there are two text files. So we are going to run a command read write.py. We are going to read from test.txt, and we are going to write to write.txt, and let's execute. So the program executed successfully, but there is no print, hence there is no output. But let's, before checking the file, let's see the files. So here you can see a new file is created, write.txt. Now let's use cat command and read the content of this file. So it clearly says it could read the content of this file. Let's read the content of test.txt file, and it's the same. So we read the content from this file, which are these three lines, and return into this file. Okay. So this is how you can read from one file and write into the another file. So here we saw two functions of the file object. When we open a file in a read mode, we use read function to read the content of the file. When we open a file in a write mode, we use write function to write content to the file. But whenever we are opening a file, whether in a read mode or a write mode, we should always make sure that we are closing that file just to avoid any of the data corruption. So hence, we should always call a close function on the file object. So let's say we have from file object dot close. So this function will close this file. Same thing for file object dot close, which will close to file object as well. This is needed. So whenever we are opening a file in a read mode or write mode, we should always make sure that we close that file so that there is no corruption of data or a file corruption. Now let's execute this program again. So let's execute it. Python read underscore write dot py test dot txt comma write dot txt. Press enter. It has executed similar way, and the content is written from the test.txt into the write.txt as we saw in the previous run. So we saw how to read from the file and how to write into the file, and also we saw some of the functions of the file, which is read and write and close. There are other functions for the file object. I would recommend to go to google.com and search for Python open function, and you should get the documentation from the Google itself. Go to the link and read the entire description as well as find out different functions which are available with the file object depending on the mode that you are opening that file object.